due to some violent content. Parental discretion is advised.
See what comes out of my mouth.
Well, I don't know what this thing is. I think it's a strip show, don't you?
Weren't there, dude.
Welcome back, guys. On today's show, why do we loot? And Costco brings back what COVID-19 took away from us. And good news, Florida, and all those to follow. Stick around for that. And a news story that might have just slipped through all the cracks with everything going on here in the past couple days. How are you? How are things? How are things going? I hope you're doing okay. And I think we need this more than anything. And what that is, if you're a listener of the show, religious listener of the show, take a deep breath, hands up over your head, and breathe out, and let's sit down and hug each other and talk this out. I was, a couple of weeks ago, I was complaining about all the stories in the news were COVID-19 and everything that's going on with that. And now the whole entire world shifted. You know, I was praying for other news articles that I could get outside of the COVID-19. Unfortunately, this has fallen into our laps. And I don't want to say fallen into our laps like we just found out about it. This has been going on for years of what's been going on. And the trials and tribulations of races and generations and all the stuff that's going on. And in my opinion, I feel, now this is not a religious show by any means. This is not a political show by any means. It's I don't want to say it's a common sense show. It's not a common sense show because we get light and fluffy. We talk about the stuff on our daily day basis of what we do here as humans, just humans in general, living on this planet that's probably going to be destroyed here in the next couple weeks or so with this freaking asteroid that NASA's been watching. But stick around for that. But I mean, we just need to sit down and talk it out and hug each other. And do we need to hug each other? Do we need to touch? Are we allowed to touch each other? But, you know, you see things on Facebook, you see, like, the news media, you see all this stuff, and when this whole thing came out, and what I'm talking about, if you've been locked in a box somewhere, is the George Floyd incident where the officer, I'm not even going to mention his name, put his knee on the gentleman's back on his neck area while arresting him, and unfortunately, he passed away. And last podcast I said, thoughts to both parties involved. It's not easy if you cause it, of course, and it's not easy when you lose someone, of course, on both sides of the fence there. But people were posting things on Facebook and people were doing all the, I'm scrolling through Facebook every night. I'm scrolling through Facebook to let the whole day catch up. If you sit there and you knee jerk and you sit there and watch it on an hourly basis, it'll drive you insane. So as we're winding down here on the French and wrapping up all our stuff and enjoying my little secluded little world that I have right here, I get on Facebook and just see what you guys are talking about and see what you guys are getting into and what's causing a ruckus amongst you guys and what news stories you're following and the anti-news stories to the anti-news stories to the the pro-news stories and whatever, and down that spiral staircase you go. And I resisted, and I don't want to say I resisted. I was smart enough not to just say anything. It's not my business. It's not my business to say anything about what is going on because there is no way on this planet I could ever understand what is going on with someone who I don't even know or a race of people I don't even know. There's no way I can understand. I sympathize. You can tell me 1 + 1 = 2, and I say, okay, all day long, 1 + 1 = 2. But when a group of people, white, black, Hispanic, Chinese, and it's weird how we put them in that order itself. Why don't we say Chinese, Hispanic, black, and then white? Why do we always go white, black, Hispanic, and then Chinese? If I was Chinese, I'd be pissed off. No, 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 Mr. Deacon. No, we're good down here. No, no, we're good. No, we don't want to cause any problems. No, no, you drop bombs on us. Remember that? No. I know. It's amazing. It's amazing. But I've resisted for a very long time about commenting on any of this stuff. You know why? Because I see people that post on Facebook and then I see another, you know, scrolling through the news feed and someone goes, you know, I've already defriended, you know, 500 people today because of their posts. I don't agree with their posts. I don't agree with the news stories they have. I don't agree with this. Well, you know what? Ding dong. That's what makes us America. That's what makes us the United States. We are allowed to value our opinions. We are allowed to have our own thoughts. Not like the people in China, not like the people overseas. If you so much step out of line, in step with what the government and everything believes, you get punished. You're gone. See you later. Now, I don't know. You're right. When I say that, you know, I shouldn't say it, but I do say it. There's I've seen videos years ago, like when Facebook in its infancy. There was videos that were coming out with when they had like riots and stuff in other countries, and you would see like four police officers. And I say police officers, they have a badge, they have some kind of militant uniform on, and they have a firearm. And the caption, it's one of those videos that now Facebook does where it says, you know, warning, and it's got the little blur over it, and it's got the little eyeball with a lightning bolt through it. Warning, you know, images might be disturbing to some people. And it shows like these four officers, three of them standing around covering the guy that they have on the ground who broke the law somehow. And instead of just picking him up and pulling him into jail, they kind of just go, anyone looking? Nope. Anyone looking? Nope. Bang, shot him in the head. And they all just kind of put the guns away. You've seen those videos. That's what goes on in other countries. Now, I don't want to say that's what happened here, but I mean, there are... What happened here was horrible. So I didn't post anything on Facebook because, heaven forbid, I say the wrong thing to the wrong side of the people on the fence. You know, we've got thousands and thousands of followers here on Facebook, and I love each and every one of you. I love each and every one of you. I hate to say one thing, and then, you know, the one-third over here says, well, I don't agree with that. Well, that's fine. You don't have to agree with it, but Jesus. Jesus Christ, people! So I haven't posted anything. And I even saw one person on Facebook say, well, I'm deleting anyone who doesn't have anything to say about this situation at all. Why? Why? Well, you need to stand up. You know, no, I'm already doing my part. I'm already doing what I can as an American, as a U.S. citizen, as a white male here in the United States. I'm already doing what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm polite. I am courteous. Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. Please and thank you. What else do you want? And that goes across the board to whoever I talk to. I don't care if you're, I don't care if you've got a Nazi friggin' symbol on your forehead. I don't care if you've got, well, I don't care if you got blue or pink hair. Blue or pink hair, you just kind of look at them and go, ah, so that's your choice, huh? But it's a style thing. It's not a personal thing. You just go, all right, well, that's that. But I mean, you know, I have been taught as a young man growing up, whether you have both parents, whether you have one parent or whatever, that you always say please and thank you, yes sir, no ma'am, yes sir, no ma'am, yes sir, no ma'am, and on the whole entire thing. You are always, it's the golden rule. Treat how you want to be treated and treat those how you want to be treated. But I understand. I understand what goes on out there. I understand that people have been held down for so long. I understand that you know, you get frustrated when you see it every day. I understand that. I can't fix it. I can fix it on my end. I can fix it in my little world. If you take a dart at a map and, you know, on the throw it at the French, and you draw a 30-mile radius around that, I'll take care of that in my area. You need to take care of that in your area. You need to take care of the problems in your area and what goes on in your area and how people treat each other. So, I mean, I was scared. I was scared to even do the podcast because I was like, who knows what's going to come out of my mouth? I might lose some fans. I might gain some fans. I don't know. I'm not looking for a fanship base. I'm just looking for just common sense. And I hate to use the word common sense because common sense hasn't worked for a very long time. So something else needs to happen. What that is, I don't know. I don't have the answer. I don't have a solution for this. The only thing I can say is I know what I'm doing on my end personally. And as long as you're doing what you think is right on your end, hopefully maybe it'll the curve, you know, we were talking about flattening the curve for the coronavirus. Maybe we can flatten the curve across the board as far as our relationships with each other. When we come back, I actually have the autopsy report from George Floyd. And it's sad. It's nothing that you don't know already, but there is a. I want to share that with you so you can hear it straight from the actual hospital that came out earlier today. And then I'll get into some a little bit of light and fluffy. But I, you know, everyone says why do when something happens we loot, we take stuff. You know, I don't like this. Give me that. You know, I'm up in arms. I'll take that. And I'll get into that here in just one sec. You're listening to Deacon Live right here on Prophet Radio. I'll be right back. Yeah, it wasn't too bad. Welcome back to Deacon Live. Give us a call at the station at any time at 407-448-8800. You can text us anytime at that same number in the Queen City studio located just outside of Charlotte, North Carolina. In a beautiful little town we like to call Marshville. And make sure you follow us on all our social networks and stuff. And the way you do that is you go to Prophet Radio, PROPHET radio.com, and click on the social contacts and you can see all the ways that you can be part of our show and connect with us and enjoy what we do here or tell your friends about us and do all the stuff that you do when you do it. Now, there you go. I did it again. Now, something that kind of pissed me off the other day, I say pissed me off. I was just kind of like, all right, you know, pick your, what is it? Pick your battles. Now, I've always been taught growing up, and I say taught, hold on. These are lessons you were taught. Can I get a full sentence out? You were taught lessons as growing up as a kid, whether, you know, don't trust anyone or trust everyone or, you know, bird in the hand is worth three in the bush or whatever the saying is or whatever those lessons are. One of the things that I came to a conclusion on myself through many years of being in the hospitality industry and being a, I don't want to say a customer service, but dealing with the public on a general level. Well, helping them sometimes in their most, I say their most, a moderate time of panic. And something I always approached when I talk to people or something happens, I always say, you never know what happened to that person 15 minutes before they got to you. You never know what happened to them or what went on or what was said or how their day was going prior to about 15 minutes to getting to you. And with that being said, I've always been positive. I say positive, you know, positive to a certain degree. Can I help you? Is there anything I can do for you? Hey, what's going on? How's your day going? Hey, what's going on, man? Even just a friendly conversation at the gas pump the other day. I was just pumping gas. Gentleman across the pump over me or across from me, I'm pumping gas and he's looking at me. I'm looking at him. And I go, you doing all right with everything? And now, granted, we're a small town of like 2,500 people. And this is before any of this started, any of the controversies and riots and started. This is just a COVID kind of checking in on your neighbors. I go, you doing okay with everything? He kind of looked at me like, you know, no one's really asked me that before outside of my family. And he kind of goes, yeah, man, older gentleman. He goes, yeah, man, I'm doing good. You doing all right? Man, I'm doing okay. And that was it. I mean, you know, just kind of, you know, brotherly love was displayed. But I mean, you never know what's going on with someone else's, you know, 15 minutes before they met you. Just approach them as, you know, I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying there, but that's the way I've always approached someone when in weird situations like that. All right, so here's the news report. I say the news report. Here is the actual death certificate. Now, do I want to get into that? I mean, we know what happened, and I'm not good at saying it. Not saying it, but you know what I'm saying. So let me put this up, and because there's a lot of technical stuff in there. I don't know. It's not my opinion. This is what the medical report said based on the actual autopsy report of George Floyd. So when I say you don't know what happened 15 minutes prior to seeing someone or meeting someone, or, you know, they have an issue or something like that, and prior to being in a conflict with them, you don't know what's going on. So obviously something happened prior to the officer showing up, prior to the anything happening. The ball started somewhere hours ago, minutes ago, days ago, before this came to a head, or what we're going into now. So, but you don't know. I mean, that's just the way I've always been, always approach stuff when things like this, when someone's in a panic or someone's, you know, hey man, you know, let's figure out what's going on. Tell me what's going on type deal. Like a negotiator. And like that guy in the Waco series, he feels good in people. I always feel good in people. I really do. I always feel good in people, no matter what they are. Again, black, white, Spanish and Chinese. But I always try to find good in people. Here's a prime example. And this just happened to me the other day. And this is 2 days ago. I was outside here on the French, mowing the lawn, getting everything, the property kind of cleaned up. We've had rain for the last couple of weeks. So the property was kind of soggy. So we had a good 3 days of sun. And I went out there and started mowing the property. So I'm mowing the property and picking up branches and trimming this and cutting this and doing all this stuff. Now, I do have road front property. If you get further, far enough away from the house, I do have property that goes up against the road. And, you know, I was out there mowing, you know, stop the mower, and I get off, and I got my little bag and stuff, and I'm picking up like branches and that are falling from the big oak tree and stuff, and I'm throwing them in the bag and stuff, and cars are flying by. I always wave, kind of give a tip of my hat. Hey, you guys doing all right? We're kind of that kind of neighborhood. Even down the little two-lane country back roads here, we kind of, on the steering wheel, you kind of give like the two fingers up. If you're watching this on the video here, go to Deacon Live, click on the podcast video, and you can see all the videos and stuff for every podcast that we do that's on the air. And so you give like a couple two fingers up, and, you know, hey, how you doing? I kind of point, you know, hey, I remember you, kind of point at them, two fingers up. Yeah, are you doing all right? Kind of that thing. You know, if you ever had a boat and you're driving down St. John's, you kind of just give them a little, hey, what's up? What's up? And you just get tired of waving, fuckers, man. Hey, gotcha. You got a boat. I got a boat. We're all waving each other. But when you're on these country two-lane roads, sometimes you'll go for a couple miles without seeing someone. So you just kind of give them the little two-finger, kind of spin it a little bit. Spin it to a point. You know what I mean? Spin the two fingers, but when you're done, you're pointing at them. Like, all right, anyways. So a car drives by in front of the house and slows down. And it's rare that cars slow down, because it's 55 miles an hour on that side of the property. So the car slows down. It's a little small mid-sized sedan, and two gentlemen are in it. And as it slows down, I can hear the motor slowing down. So I kind of turn my head to see why is someone slowing down on this highway. Because if you slow down long enough, these big chicken trucks are running through here. You know, it's 60, 70 miles an hour. They'll plow right into the back of you. So I kind of turn my head, and sure enough, as soon as I turn my head, I see the passenger flip an old beer can out the window, spins around, and lands in the brush across the street. He gets out of the car, and I guess they must have hit something or something. There's like damage to the underskirt of this little mid-sized sedan in the little apron. So he's trying to pull it up and put it back together because I guess it's scraping on the ground. And I'm standing there. I got my headphones on. I'm a sight to see when I'm out there doing yard work. I got my sunglasses on. I got my headband on. And I've got my mask on my face. I look like a terrorist. I got a mask on my face because it's dusty out there. And I got these big, huge, my JBL. Thank you very much, JBL, sponsor of the DeaconLive podcast. I got my big, huge JBL Bluetooth wireless headphones on. And I almost took them off for a second and yelled, "Hey, pick that shit up." But I didn't, because I was in my mind, I'm like going, all right, you don't know exactly that split second. You don't know what happened to these two guys. You don't know what was going on, why they had to pull over, and they pulled this apron up. It kind of just all like one and one and one and one and one and one and one adds up to nine, whatever the math is on that math. And I didn't want to stir up anything or cause any problems. Nothing to see here, folks. No problems going on. But I didn't want to stir up a hive that I had no involvement in. He threw a beer can out. He fixed whatever on the apron of the front of the car. He jumped in. Car took off down the road. No license plate, by the way. Imagine that. Took off down the road. And I kind of just looked and I watched him go up over the hill and back down and disappear. I'm like, God, ain't that some shit? So now I got to stop everything I'm doing because I'm good friends with the guy across the street. He's got a horse farm over there as well. And one of these, the beer can was sitting in one of his pastures. So I walked over there, climbed underneath the ditch, grabbed the beer can. You know, it's a highway. Stuff flies out of people's cars all the time. I got shit all in my garage here of weird shit that have fallen off of people's cars, like tools and stuff. That's kind of weird. But, you know, it's just garbage. You know, you see them on the side of the highway, people picking up garbage and stuff from cars passing through and debris flying out. But this was I literally watched the beer can spiral because it was like half full in slow motion, like it was spilling out beer as he flips it out of the window. And I go over there and I'm like, oh, man, come on. Come on, man. What are you doing? What are you doing? But I didn't say anything because, again, I didn't know what happened to him. These two guys, 15 minutes before they come down my road and pick up their front of their skirt. So I was just worried about, I didn't want to cause any problems. So there you go. That's my little story. When we come back, we'll get into why we actually loot. And then I promise you, we'll get light and fluffy and have a little bit of fun and try to get our minds off of what's going on. Our minds should always be on this topic, but just to relax a little bit, take a deep breath, sit back, enjoy a beer, and we'll continue with Deacon Live. Stick around. You're listening to Deacon Live right here on Prophet Radio. I'll be right back. This is going to be a weird transition. Welcome back to Deacon Live. Welcome back to Deacon Live. This segment is brought to you by RT Planning Strategies. Do you want to transform? Do it every time. Stop. Well, you didn't give me a script. It's stupid. All right. Welcome back to Deacon Live. This segment's brought to you by RT Planning Strategies. Do you want to transform your organization to be more productive? Do you want to run your organization more efficiently? Do you want to generate more revenue? And do you want to be more successful? Go to RTPlanningStrategies.com. Since 1991, Ron has redefined and evolved his process in planning your business with future revenue in mind. That's RTPlanningStrategies.com. Now, hold on, make sure, because that's going to be a weird segment here. I want to get into something a little creeper. Oh, but oh, well. I was talking about the asteroid. The asteroid that's coming to Earth that's going to wipe us all out. Yeah, I mean, you always hear about, you know, the dinosaurs and what wiped out the dinosaurs. Well, guess what? NASA. Hold on, where's it at? I got to find the right damn article here. Hold on. NASA is keeping tabs on a massive asteroid that's coming closer to Earth every day. Put it over here. I put a brand new light in here so I could read a little bit better. These other lights aren't working very well. Let's see. The space agency... It's on the wrong side. Unplug you. Move you over here. And there we go. Does that look good on the camera? Can you see that? Yeah? Okay. Thank you. NATHA. He's my Titan. The space agency website has an asteroid watching section showing the next five approaches, which are expected to hit in the next few days. Actually, they're expected to fly by in the next few days. The largest asteroid estimated to be 1,100 feet wide, of approximately the size of a football stadium, named 202NN4. They should just call it Stadium Crusher or something like that. Is expected to come closest to the Earth here on June 6th. So you got a couple days to get your shit together just in case something happens. However, scientists don't expect there will be any collision with the Earth. The closest that it'll approach is 3,160,000 miles away. 160,000, yeah, that's what I said. There are three other the size of planes and one of the size of a house. I like how they do the planes and houses and the reference there. Also making their way towards Earth in the next few days. Scientists don't believe that there are any concerns with these asteroids since the closest one is expected to come within 1.83 million miles from the Earth here on Wednesday. Quick! If you're listening to this podcast and it's Thursday, we survived. All right? So there you go. So be careful out there. There's a bunch of asteroids flying by us. And you know, it's not for nothing. I was watching something, the universe or something on Netflix, and we'll get into the Netflix shows here in a little bit, what we watched and what flopped. The whole thing about, like, the first three episodes of the universe on Netflix was really interesting about the sun and everything, and then, you know, they started getting crazy into other planets, and I was like going, shoo, you lost me. Completely lost me. Now, what loses a lot of people is they always say... why do we, you know, the building, I say building, our team lost. Let's go break some shit. Something like this happens. Something, unfortunately, the George Floyd thing happened where he passed away at the hands of incongruent with the hands of a police officer has passed away. And so it brings a lot of negative feelings. Everyone wants to go out there and protest. Everyone wants to go out there. And all of a sudden, everyone starts looting. And a lot of people, and I even played the video last week on why are you burning down your own place? Why are you looting, burning down your own city? Well, I did some research on actually why this actually happens between protesters and looters. They're two totally different people. Get my page again. So here's the deal. So the question that everyone always asks is, why do they always loot? Why do they always break into buildings and steal everything out of there? They're stealing TVs and baby food. I'm hitting the damn lights here. I'm waving my hands in the air. Stealing TVs and baby foods and, you know, baseball cards. That's what I would do. I'd go in there and grab all the baseball cards. But that's just me because I know they'll be worth money someday. Not like the TVs, half of them probably broken by the time you get them home. Oh, I mean, you ever tried moving one of those big 60-inch screen TVs in a box, laying on at least nine of them sitting on a flat cart? You're gonna lose one of them. You're gonna lose them. You're gonna crack the screen or something. Christ, we had a 34-inch or 37-inch that we were moving up here to North Carolina, completely wrapped in bubble wrap and everything in a container. I say a container, one of those pod things. And sure enough, when it got here, cracked. So, all right. So, why? The question is, why do we loot? Why do we burn? Why do we break down and destroy our community and our neighborhood. Well, for one thing, looters and peaceful protesters aren't typically the same person. Dana Fisher, a Scientologist from University of Maryland, did this study. And this is a study of the last 20 years. And she says it's rare for a peaceful protester to start stealing and setting fires at random. People flock to a site of a protest with different motivations. And those who want peace tend to stay peaceful. And she says, I've never seen someone who comes to a peaceful protest and then say, hey, they just broke out a window. I'm going to go over there and now start stealing stuff. So the peaceful people stay peaceful. And those that are looting have various motives and motivations and why they are looting. Vandalism during the protests focus on objects and buildings that are quote-unquote symbolic for other values. For example, people are more likely to attack symbols of authority such as like the CNN building that we just saw, police cars, and you know, all the authority stuff flipped over and burned and stuff, rather than seeing like the apartments or the townhomes that are close by, they never really get touched. Now, in this way, some of the looting is seen lashing out against capitalism, the police and other forces that are seen to perpetuate racism. As perpetuating racism. So that's why you see them, you know, punching and kicking all the police cars and stuff. And the one lady took her shirt off, took her pants off, took a dump on the flipped upside down police car. Easy, folks, easy. It's not one of those kind of ladies. She's not like a centerfold model. She is completely gross and gross for taking a dump on the car. So widespread looting then may perhaps be interpreted as a kind of mass protest against our dominant conception of property. This is kind of what she was saying is, it's a bid for redistribution of property. Andrea Boyles found out that when she interviewed dozens of people during the Ferguson unrest, one of her interviews saw that looting from a Quick Trip convenience store as redistribution for the economic exploitation of black communities. A man that she will call Ted said he didn't care about looting the store, especially if they had insurance. He spent money at the store in his community. Ted also told her, but when he found himself low on cash, there was nowhere for him to turn. So looting to him is a result only of mild suffering for a store owner who did little to alleviate the suffering in his own community. So that's kind of the mindset. And I understand that. I understand looting in that sense. You know, here are these stores. It's kind of like the LA riots. I'm a big fan of Ice Cube. I'm a big fan of all his albums, NWA and thereafter. I liked his stuff. And he says, when you go down to the Korean store, they always look at you. And these Koreans are making money selling, you know, alcohol, cigarettes. I don't think they sell firearms. I don't think the Koreans can get a firearm license. But, I mean, for the most part, they're selling alcohol and cigarettes to these black communities. So when the riots happen, of course, they're going to go down there and whip the Koreans' ass because, hey, you made us. I don't want to say they made them this way, but you understand what I'm saying. So they go after what these communities, these stores, these businesses are. I guess they're mad because they're a symbol of capitalism and they're not giving back to the community. Well, maybe that should change. Maybe there should be more giving back to the community. Now, granted, I know what you're saying out there. Who's to say that the guy who owns Target, the company that owns Target, has given millions and millions to, you know, black college funds and the NCAA and the NCAAP and all those letters? Unfortunately, I don't know them right offhand. But who's to say? But here on the ground level, on ground zero, we don't see that. What if you were to have, hey, here's the Target college fund for blah, blah, blah. Here is the CNN college fund, the black and Negro College Fund based on CNN. Here is, why don't they start doing that? If everyone, I say everyone, those companies out there, big companies, those companies, you know who I'm talking about. Big companies out there start doing the, it doesn't take much. It doesn't take much to send one person through college. To pay for everything is what? Community college. Let's say you're going to go get your associates. $36,000? $36,000. That's books and everything. That's not including boarding. That's $36,000. You can get a pretty damn good education for $36,000 and walk away with something. Even if you have low grades in high school and stuff, if you had an incentive to go to college and even had an opportunity, hey, guess what? You know, what's $36 million to a bunch of people? What's the math? $36 million divided by 36,000. Hold on. Get my calculator out. Hope you're watching at home. 36,000,000 divided by 36,000. It's 1,000 people. 1,000 people. Now, granted, we have what, 5.6 billion people on this planet, and 376 million live here in the United States. I mean, well, let's spread it out there. Let's get these big corporations to start financing and funding more education for these people who aren't as fortunate enough to have opportunities to be better. You know, you think this is it. By the age of 14, this is it. This is all I'm going to do. All right. Did I lose you? I didn't lose you, did I? I hope not. Stick around. We're going to get into a little bit more of the show. We're going to be a little bit light and fluffy. And by the way, one more thing for those looters out there. Check that phone that you just got. I got a message for you. It'll be coming here soon. Stick around. You're listening to Deacon Live right here on Prophet Radio. I'll be right back. Welcome back to Deacon Live. My good friend IT Dan called me during the break, and I'm like, I'm glad you called because I needed someone to talk to. I needed someone to talk to outside of you guys. I love talking to you guys. I talk to you guys on a weekly basis here on Deacon Live, and I wanted someone else's outside physical verbal opinion outside of just reading like the Facebook stuff. So I was talking to Dan there for a little bit. So I'm sorry if I kept you on hold for very long. And some other guys, if you want to hear something else, another great podcast, some good friends of ours just started up this great podcast called The Asylum Podcast. The Asylum Podcast is hosted by Marv and Meyer Lansky, and they're talking about ignorant shit and giving their views and opinions on topics that spring from their minds, springs to their minds, as well as some serious topics. I would right now go down and click on the link on prophetradio.com. You can find their little banner right there. They're going to be talking a lot about this stuff a little bit more in depth than I can or I will. And it should be interesting to hear. Oh, fuck this. Stop. Delete. Yes. Done. Welcome back to Deacon Live. I hope I didn't keep you in the wings too long. I was on the phone with IT Dan. And it's good to just talk to someone else outside of the French and those knuckleheads that are on Facebook and stuff, and just get their opinions about what's going on verbally, you know, an interaction back and forth. And so I was talking to him, and I'll post that interview up on the Prophet Radio website under the shared on, under the Deacon Live. So go to Deacon Live and click on the shared on section. While you're at prophetradio.com, some good friends of mine have just started a new podcast. It's called The Asylum Podcast. The Asylum Podcast is just two regular guys, my friends Marv and Meyer Lansky, talking about ignorant shit, giving their views and opinions on every topic that springs into their mind, as well as some serious topics that are going on in the world today. And I'm sure they probably got a mouthful and a microphone full of stuff that's been going on here in the past couple days, if not weeks. So make sure you go over to Prophet Radio, P-R-O-P-H-E-T radio.com, and click on the Asylum Podcast, a little banner there. Takes you right to their new podcast that's up on iTunes. Give them a like, give them a share, tell them you heard about them here on Deacon Live. And it's great. It's a great podcast. It's two guys Marv and Meyer Lansky, and you can follow them on Twitter as well, the Meyer Lansky, and also the Realist Marv on Twitter. So follow them as well. They post up a bunch of stuff there. So we were talking about Apple users or people that have stolen stuff from the Apple stores. Guess what? Apple is no ding-dong. Apple is actually has... I'm moving a bunch of papers around here. I need a secretary. Secretary! Where you at? Thieves who made off with iPhones from Apple stores are quickly learning that some of the gadgets that were loaded with special security software. It displays a special message for the looters that have stolen these phones. We know where you are. We're coming for your children. Make sure you bring these phones back. You'll never be able to sell them. That type of stuff. So anyone that is going to buy one of these phones from these looters or anywhere out there, the iPhones, most of the Apple software, anything from the Apple store has a security thing on it, and they can track you. It's kind of like Find My iPhone type thing. So you'll get a little message, and then guess what? They're going to come find you. Bing! Shut up! Bing! Shut up! Bing! Shut up! I got to go! So I got good news for everyone. Let's do some good news, right? Let's do some good news. So the whole coronavirus obviously has been completely shot in the ass, pun intended, shot in the ass. No one's going to obey the rules anymore, not after all this shit that's been going down. So people in Florida, actually people who go like grocery shopping and stuff, we used to have a membership for like Costco and BJ's and Sam's Club, depending on what region you're from, depending on what suppliers out there. There we go. So since the coronavirus has taken over and we have gotten out of control as far as touching stuff and doing stuff, now Costco has announced that they are unsuspending their food sample program. That's right. After 3 long months, Costco has finally revealed that they will be reintroducing free samples in June. The food court reopened late May, and we're going to start doing some of the things in mid-June to slow roll out the basics in sampling. And isn't that what you went for at Costco? You went there to get all the sampling and stuff? So Costco right now is in mid-June, nationwide, is going to start rolling out the free sampling and stuff. Now, how are they going to do that when they're still shutting down? I say they're shutting down. They're slowing down buffet-style type restaurants. Isn't that kind of a buffet-style restaurant? I mean, free samples? Free samples! Come get this. You ever seen the old ladies that do it? They take forever. They don't care. They take forever. You have a line of, you can always tell the good stuff. And they have a line of, like, pizza rolls. And they're taught to, you know, push this, promote this. And they just sit there and go, how much longer? You go, how much longer for the pizza rolls? Huh? For the pizza rolls, and think, yeah. It's 4 minutes. So it's, and she rolls up her vintage Little House on the Prairie outfit, sleeve, and with the ruffles around the wrist. So 11:25, you can come back. Fuck that. I'm sitting right there. Because 11:24, it's going to be a line out the door just for those free samples. So there you go. Costco's opening up their free samples. I never got into the free samples. I just went there for the deals. No matter what you put in your cart, it's always $20. No matter what, they will figure out a way to make it $5, $10, or $20. Oh, I got a box of cereal. I got a box of cereal here, Joe. How do I make it $5? Put two of them together. That'll make it $10. Put four of them together. You know, and they tie them up. Everything, no matter what you get at Costco, it's always $5, $10, or $20. And you get 10 items of the $20. Guess what? Your bill's $200. And we walk out there, it's like $500. I'm like, God damn! Damn! It's goddamn Costco. And they say, oh, well, it'll last for weeks. It'll last for weeks. The shit I buy, before that we weren't buying. Anyway, it doesn't last for weeks because we don't use it. We don't use it. And another thing that's opening up, and I know Florida itself is happy that Governor Ron DeSantis, one, is probably going to get the Republican primary or the caucus down there. Because Trump doesn't want to come up here to North Carolina because I guess him and the governor here are fighting. I told you, not political. I can get very political if you want. We can go round and round in circles. But I just thought I'd throw that out there because that's what's on the Facebook feed and everyone wants to make a big deal about nothing. I'm not saying that the whole riots were nothing, but I'm just saying the whole governor and Trump. Anyways, back to what I was talking about. Ron DeSantis says that movies, bars, theaters, and entertainment businesses can reopen in Florida as the ease of COVID-19 restrictions are lifted. Governor made this announcement Wednesday afternoon, a few hours right here before the show, as he outlined Florida's phase two of reopening its economy during the press conference at NBC Sports Grill and Brew at Universal Studios City Walk. I've never been there. Never been to the NBC one. I've been to the NBA one out on Disney property, but I haven't been to the NBC one. Phase two goes into effect on Friday and applies to all bars and clubs in all of the three southeastern Florida counties with the highest rates of COVID-19. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, shit. Hold on, I read that wrong. All but the three southeastern counties with the highest rates of COVID-19. Miami-Dade, Broward County, and Palm Beach counties. Well, guess what, guys? You guys are shit out of luck. Because you guys suck down there in Miami. You guys say you suck. But you're the one that spread. Well, I blame the Super Bowl for most of that. Because they did have a bunch of Super Bowl people down there across the world. And all of a sudden, all the cases popped up down there at the old Miami Dolphins arena or wherever they football sports. Yay. The bars will be operated at a half capacity inside and full capacity outside. And you know how Florida weather is and for people eating outside, get ready to break out the umbrellas between 2 and 3 o'clock because it rains and then it goes away. And then you're all stuck with everything being washed down and hot and sticky. Patrons may also receive service if seated restaurants may allow bar-top seatings with social distancing as well. Although bars have been closed since March 17th, governor shut them down, blah, blah, blah. So this is the first step of opening stuff up. Now, if Florida, you know, here it is. This was just released today on Wednesday. And Florida and all the riots and stuff that have been going on, there's no reason not to open up everything else. Or do you want to open up everything else? Do you want to have people in these establishments with Hopefully today is, I don't know, however many days of this been going on, but would you want to? Would you want to risk that? Well, for the most part, I think most businesses are trying to get back into the action. And someone that else is getting back into the action is, this little story kind of snuck through. You know, the first of the year we were talking about, you know, pandemic and everyone stays at home and everyone needs to not go outside. So what do? You sit there and binge watch TV and you binge watch whatever. And this show, Tiger King, I always want to call it Tiger Kingdom. It's Tiger King. I've said it a million times. People are like, are you talking about the tire store? Tiger Kingdom? No, Tiger King. So if you're not familiar with this, Tiger King, I don't know if I need to switch screens, but I will. So here's a little news story that might have slipped through the cracks with all the stuff going on here. Tiger King, the show, Carol Baskin gets control of Joe Exotic's zoo. Now you're saying, well, how the hell does she get in, you know, control of a zoo that's not even hers, and how does she get it? Well, here you go. Oh, God, thank you. Carol Baskin scored a major victory on her ongoing feud with Joe Exotic. On Monday, a federal judge in Oklahoma ruled in her favor of Baskin's Big Cat Rescue Corporation. Hey there, cats and kittens. That will allow her to take control of the zoo formerly owned by her nemesis. Now, you say, well, how does she get control of that? Now, if you watch the series and stuff, Joe Exotic kind of ripped off her logo and kind of ripped off her trademark to, on his own end, to try to sell and do his own. It's trademark infringement is actually what happened. So she sued him. And here's the story. The order is part of a $1 million trademark judgment against Joe Exotic that was never really paid in full. Baskin and Exotic's rivalry was documented on the hit series, blah, blah, blah. The Big Cat owner's feud dates back from over decades, with their legal war starting in about 2011. Baskin sued Exotic for trademark infringement and won in 2013. He was ordered to pay her $1 million, which didn't happen. In 2016, Big Cat Rescue sued Exotic's mother, Shirley whatever, for fraudulent transfer of the GW Exotic Memorial Park into her name, as this played out in the docuseries. All right, so basically what happened was he didn't have enough money to pay her, so they seized his assets. It's a, you know, court hearing, judge ruling and stuff. So they seized his assets, even though it was in what's her name's what's his name, the Joe Webb guy, the douchebag, the 50-year-old douchebag wearing a afflicted shirts and stuff. Yep, took it from him. He had no right to buy it. It was still in his name, and so Carol Baskin now owns two Tire Kingdoms. There you go. That's the new episode, Tire Kingdoms. I said, you know, because there's a lot of Hollywood people out there that are into, like, saving animals and helping endangered species and stuff. Tim Robbins actually was interested in helping Carol to pursue saving endangered animals and stuff. And the only thing was, when Tim Robbins was going to give her money, she had to change the name of the place from. Hold on, I'm going to get to the joke here in a minute. From Baskin's Big Cat Rescue to Baskin and Robbins, Tim Robbins throwing money out there. All right, when we come back, I'm going to tell you what not to watch and what not to listen to. Part of it being me. Stick around. You're listening to Deacon Live right here on Proper Radio. I'll be right back. Awful. Welcome back to Deacon Live. Make sure you follow us on all our social networks and stuff. And the way you do that is go to Prophet Radio, P-R-O-P-H-E-T, radio.com. Click on the Deacon Live section and actually click on the social contacts connection. You can see all the platforms that you are available to subscribe to, share to, like to, comment on, do all that for us. And while you're there, click on Deacon Live. You can see the video from us. Every podcast has a video, and you can click on that, and you can see that as well. And we just heard, by the way, Red Dots from our good friend Sam Z. And you can find him on Spotify. That's Sam Z, S-A-M-Z-Y, Sam Z with Red Dots. I still love that song. Take a note here. I got to play. I forgot to click out Mikey Hampton's new song. Mikey Hampton's new song. All right. Song. Oops. All right. What? Okay. Forgot what I was talking about. While you're there, you can click on all our sponsorships and stuff and get your moment of zen right there on the top crawler there. Click on that video, and sometimes you just need a laugh. Sometimes you just need to get away for a little bit. Click on that little moment of zen. Click on that and enjoy. I think it's about 5-6 minutes long, and help you relax for a little bit. A little personal moment of zen there. All right, so what you should be watching, I know the whole Netflix, no one's really asking to watch on Netflix anymore. No one's watching for anything or asking for anything to watch anymore. Everyone's kind of binged out. Everyone's kind of done with watching TV. And I think kind of in tandem with this whole George Floyd thing, it's a very tongue-twisted name to say for me. It was a perfect storm. Everyone's been trapped inside. We've been told not to go out. We've been told not to do anything. We've been told not to, and then we get released a little bit, and we get released a little bit, but you have to go outside with mask on, and it's kind of like that perfect storm where I can go out with a mask on, and then this happens, and then, oh my God, and the whole world falls apart, and there's police cars on fire. It's kind of that perfect storm. Now, I'm going to tell you a couple. I know that's kind of a, it's kind of a, like a an apex that I just kind of got away from. But there's a couple shows on Netflix that are coming out now that might be getting lost. There's a lot of shows out there on Netflix that are getting lost on the wayside. I don't know if they're good or I don't know if they're bad, but we kind of watch them here and I'm gonna play them for you, and then I'm going to give you my opinion on that. So right now, my wife said, let's watch this show. It looks kind of cute. And it's called Never Have I Ever. And it's a new show on Netflix, a new series on Netflix. So here's a little trailer for you right now.
What? Mom, I'm fast asleep.
You don't look like you're asleep.
What are you doing here?
I'm doing exactly what I said I'd do. I'm here to have sex with you.
Gonna be our year. You can feel it.
But we're not cool. Would a not cool person wear one dangly earring?
Which brings me to my plan. We're rebranding. I have chosen attainable yet status-enhancing people for each of us to date.
Hey, Jonah. You smell great today.
It's Forever by Mariah Carey.
Oh. This is why you don't mess with me. See, I'm technically best there ever be. Yes, I'm blessed indeed. So don't test me, please. I am Hercules. I unleash the beast. You look like an Indian Kardashian.
I want to talk about a major event that could happen. Popping my cherry, Doc.
Oh, Lord.
We are smart, and idiots are banging all the time. We can learn how to do it, too.
Word of advice, just give up.
Oh, yeah? I won't be able to walk again tomorrow because I'm about to go get railed. Peace out, virgin.
You just seem lost.
And I'm not lost. High school's a dick.
Are we allowed to say dick now?
I just want to be a normal teenager.
Whoa, what are you doing?
Don't worry, he won't hurt me.
Normal teenagers end up in prison. Or worse, working in Jersey Mike's. In a situation, you don't
know what to say. You're a weird girl.
Yes, I am. Buckle up for some steamy teen romance.
Oh, shit.
So that's a new series on Netflix called Never Have I Ever. And it's kind of funny. It follows this Indian girl. It's from the comedy minds of Mindy Kaling. You know her from the Office. And she had her own show. Now, speaking of from the Office, holy Jesus. Have you seen this one yet? Steve Carell is in a new series called Space. Oh, let me tell you about Never Have I Ever. It's fun. It's a girl show. It's well written, very well written, very well shot. The characters are great. Everyone has their own personal characters and quirks and jerks and all that stuff. But it talks about like girl issues, about losing their virginity, like going into high school and stuff. And I just kind of checked out because I was like, well, you know, it's not really my thing. I mean, high school, of course, and losing your virginity. Christ, I wasn't, you know, I wasn't until I met my wife. Right? Everyone out there shaking your head, yes, you know. So it's kind of like, you know, lose your virginity in high school, and this girl's on a mission to do it. And she's an Indian girl, so she's kind of outcast, kind of a nerd girl. And when I say Indian, not the woo woo woo, I'm talking about the dot on the forehead. Oh my God, what was I talking about the whole show and I do that? I'm sorry. Deacon at ProfitRadio.com. All right, so here's the news show. Speaking of The Office, Steve Carell has kind of spoofed, actually, again, from writer Greg Daniels, who brought you The Office and some of The Simpsons and that show Upload that I was talking about earlier, past couple podcasts. It was all right. It wasn't horrible, but this, Jesus Christ, this is Space Force, starring Steve Carell.
I want to welcome our newest four-star general, Mark Naird, formerly number two at the Air Force.
Thank you. It has always been my dream to command a service branch.
Our nation's internet runs through our vulnerable space satellites. POTUS wants complete space dominance. To that end, the president is creating a new branch, Space Force, which Mark will run.
What? This is a great adventure we are embarking on today. There will be setbacks, but greatness was never won without sacrifice.
Oh, he is blowing it just like you thought. Yeah, it is a complete shit show. Oh, my dry cleaner. Yeah, they lost my dress wipes.
Space should be a zone of wonder, not of conflict and death.
As a scientist, you have a loyalty to reason. Makes you a little untrustworthy.
How much was that prototype?
4 million?
Middle schools. Cost as much as 4 new middle schools.
Fuck!
Are you running?
No, keep up.
Your attitude seems to be, give us money and don't look while we militarize space.
You are running.
Keep up. Hey, bud, what are you doing?
Got suspended. Gave a teacher the finger.
His blood pressure is spiking.
Brad,
no interruptions for 5 minutes.
Aruba, Jamaica. Take you, Bermuda, Bahama, pretty mama. Bodies in the sand. Tropical drinks melting in your hand. We'll be falling in love to the rhythm of a steel drum band. Down in
our country put a man on the moon. Well, guess what, kids? We're going back.
So that's Space Force with Steve Carell. And there's a bunch of John Malkoviches in it. There's a lot of good people in this. I don't know if it was my frame of mind. When I was watching it, but it felt like I wanted to see, well, I'm in the middle of watching The Office series again for the third time, because my wife has never watched it, so we were watching it again for the third time. I thought it would be great if Steve Carell left, you know, The Office, and then for some reason joined the military, and he worked his way up through the ranks, because he's a great talker if you ever watch The Office. Got a 4-star general promotion in the service, and they gave him this thing, and now he's running it as Michael Scott. It would have been great, but it's not. I'm looking for that Michael Scott character. Maybe that's my flaw. I'll give it I watched the first episode and I was like, ugh, save me. I'll give it a couple more watches and then I'll tune you guys in. Speaking of tuning you guys in, I'd like to thank each and every one of you for tuning us in and giving us the time of day. I'd like to thank all you guys out there for contacting us through email and giving us all your stories, all your photos and everything. And the way you can do that is go to deacon@profitradio.com, or you can be part of the show. Click on the Be Heard section on Profit Radio. Go to Prophet Radio. Click on Be Heard, and that way you can also be part of the podcast and you can be heard. We'll play right here during the podcast. On behalf of all you guys out there taking the time to be with us, I'd like to thank you guys. I'm going to let you get back to what you got to do. My name is the Deacon, saying goodnight and goodnight.
Fight it!
Boo!
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 Oh, no.
the end. The absolute end.
Écoute-moi.
Sorry, I had to do that. Had to remind the article I didn't use with Dan. All right, guys, thank you. Take care. Good night. Jazz fingers. Stupid.